Equilibrium and ice tables. We start with a container filled with only A. The pressure is 12 atmospheres at a temperature of 25.0 degrees Celsius. The following equilibrium is established. The total pressure is 16 atmospheres. What is the value of standard delta G for this reaction, staying at a constant 25 degrees Celsius? In this question, we have a reactant that dissociates, and we need to find the pressures at equilibrium. This is a good hint that tells us we need to use an ICE table. We can use ICE tables with values for concentration, moles, and pressure. At the start, we only have A at 12 atmospheres. No B or C has been produced at this point. A certain amount X of reactant A will dissociate to produce B and C. This amount is multiplied by the stoichiometric coefficients of each compound, so the reaction will produce 3 times more compound C than compound B. This is what we will have at equilibrium. According to Dalton's law of partial pressures, the total pressure of all the gases in the container will be equal to the sum of the partial pressures of each gas. Since we know that the total pressure is 16 atmospheres, we can determine the value of X using algebra. Note that here the zeros aren't written in the intermediate calculations, but the value of X is actually precise to 2 digits after the decimal because our calculation was an addition. We insert the value of X to determine the partial pressures at equilibrium. Now we can calculate the equilibrium constant of the reaction, and then from there, the value of delta G. The partial pressures are put into the equilibrium constant equation in the same way that we would do for concentrations in moles. Their stoichiometric coefficient becomes their exponent. To go from the equilibrium constant to delta G, we use the following equation. Putting in the values gives us an answer in kilojoules, and we round to 3 digits because all the data we put into the equation had 3 significant digits.